So by this protocol, used surgical instruments are considered as potentially infected. So they have to be handled in that particular manner. Okay. So this has implications on the design, in that a separate cleaning area is required in the CSSD. Instruments should not be washed in the scrub basin. So the scrub basins will again get contaminated. In case there is an infection, when you are scrubbing, it will come on your hands. Okay. Second thing is, there should be a cleaning area separate from other areas where they are packing drums, the autoclave is kept. So even in the CSSD room, even if you have one single room, make sure there's a separate basin, and if possible, it is partitioned off from the rest of the room. So this segregation of clean and dirty needs to be maintained. Okay. Next thing is, exposed surfaces will catch microbes continuously. This is a fact. We cannot change this. And second thing is, sterilization methods, autoclaving, ETO, gas plasma, they kill only a fixed number of organisms in a given period of time. So this concept I will explain in detail more later. But remember, even if you do sterilization correctly, there are no guarantees. Nobody in the world can give a guarantee. Okay? So this has again implications on the CSSD design. Because of this, once we wash an instrument, we have to make sure it does not get recontaminated again. Because your sterilization process is going to kill only a fixed number of microbes. So if you start out with more, then something may remain back. So because of that, the area where you pack the drums and trays, that has to be very clean to prevent the recontamination. So ideally, a separate clean area is required for packing instruments. Linen also usually comes to this area. And the cleaned instruments have to be done packing immediately as soon as they are ready. They should not leave it lying open and then do the packing 2 hours later. So it has to be one continuous process. Only then it will work properly. So why is it important to prevent recontamination? So cleaning and sterilization are blind processes. We cannot see the bacteria being killed. There is no real-time test to measure the bacteria on a surgical instrument after autoclaving. And we cannot do it in practice. The very act of sampling will make it unsterile. Okay? So if you see the definitions of a sterilization method, suppose I invent a method tomorrow. I want to get it classified as a sterilization method. Then my method has to satisfy two criteria. One is, it should kill large number of bacterial spores. Second thing, it should give me a 10 log reduction in the bacterial count. So what is 10 raised to 6 logs? What is that? Suppose I start out with 10 raised to 6 bacteria on the instrument. So ekavar saha shunya, that is 10 raised to 6. Then at the end of my process, there should be 1 or 0 bacteria left on my instrument. In other words, there is a 1 in a million chance that one single viable organism is left on the instrument. If my process satisfies both of this, then I will call it as a sterilization method. Okay? So 10 raised to 6 has to become 0. Now every time I use this method, it is going to give me the same reduction. So suppose I start out with 10 raised to 20. My operation will be correct, my machine will do proper, my sterilization indicators will pass, everything will be fine. But what about the count reduction? I will get only a 10 raised to 6, 6 log reduction, not 10 raised to 20 reduction. So something can remain back. So this is why it is important to prevent recontamination after the cleaning, and that's the most important basis for CSSD design. Okay? So this is what I just explained now. Okay? So these are the major areas in an ideal CSSD. If you have the space, you can go in for all these four separate areas. First is the instrument receipt and cleaning, where we have the dirty work is there. Blood, body fluids, all those things will come there. Here, the air has to be exhausted directly outside. You can install a simple exhaust fan also in the room where you're above your basin. That also should be sufficient. And separation from other areas is required. So this should be partitioned off, even if you're doing it in a small room. Second area is the inspection and packaging. So after cleaning and drying, the instruments will come to this. Linen will also come here. And here the drum trays will get packed. Sterilization indicators will be added here. All this is clean activity from this point onwards. So again, this has to be separate. And here, ideally, we need temperature control. Because again, if you have more humidity and moderate temperatures, higher temperatures, it encourages bacterial growth. So packing area of the CSSD, actually, if you see the Western guidelines, they have air supply just like the OT. They have an AHU, they have a HEPA filtered air supply, they have about 6 to 12 air changes per hour, humidity is controlled, and the staff is completely separate. That is what is an ideal CSSD. But again, all this is not possible in our settings. So in our CSSD, some amount of risk will always be there of recontamination. Okay? Third area is a sterilizer. So this has to be isolated just for the sake of heat control, not for infection point of view. So autoclaves, they go up to 121, 135 degrees Celsius. So the huge, there's a lot of heat. So that's the reason why they are isolated. And once you unload all these things, then you have an area where you have to keep the sterile containers, drums, trays, in a secure manner away from dust and liquids. So that for that, a separate sterile storage area is usually requested. So these are the four main areas in any CSSD, ideal CSSD. Plus you have the associated ones like changing room, then toilet for the CSSD staff, dining room, and their own. It's just like another OT complex in the major OT complex. It's just a replica of the same. Okay. So these are the major areas. Okay. In practice, this is what we can do. If you have the space, then you can try to fit in the four areas and all the associated rooms. If you have the space, that's the main limitation in India right now. In an existing setup, if you have a big enough room, you can set up all these activities in the same room with simple partitions. And if you don't have even that much space also, then you can just separate only the cleaning area, because the rest, all the three areas are clean areas that we can combine. Okay? So the dirty area should be separated, a separate exhaust should be put, the packing and other areas can be combined, and the sterile material can be stored in closed cupboards in that same area or in another location in the OT complex. So the last choice will be the OT itself. Okay. So here it is important to restrict traffic in this room, because again, as I said, the more people going into that area, higher is the recontamination of the washed instruments. So CSSD need not always be huge. You can maintain this even in a small, but the work practices has to be very correct. So the staff training and all those issues will come here. Okay. So regarding staff, ideally cleaning section staff is separate, other staff is separate, but not practically possible here. So in our setups, we have to train them to separate the clean and dirty work. So simple examples, like after they do the instrument cleaning, wash hands, use a hand rub, and then start packing the instruments. That's olya hatani dhutlele instrument pusun pack karayche nahit. So ashi simple goshti we have to teach them. Then those instruments which are received from the OT, they should be kept at the cleaning basin only. Alele instrument ekda ikade thevle, ekda tikade thevle, ekda packing table thevle, asa karayche nahi. So blood body fluid sagle eka thikani, asa segregation tane shikvayche. Biomedical waste barach ves CSSD madhe nikte, because gauze pads and other things, they come with the trays to the CSSD cleaning area. So there should be a biomedical waste bins for those disposal, and that this should be correctly segregated. Then after unloading the autoclave, they should keep the containers in the cupboard immediately. म्हणजे बाहेर ड्रम काढून काउंटरवर ठेवला मग कुठं चहा प्यायला गेला मग आल्यावर टकपाट ठेवला असं नाही. काढला की इमिजिएटली होल्स बांधून इमिजिएटली शूड गो इन टू द स्टोरेज. सो इफ यू फॉलो दीज प्रॅक्टिसेस देन इवन इन अ स्मॉल रूम वी कॅन मॅनेज दी स्टरलायझेशन क्वाईट इफेक्टिवली. ओके, सो दिस ऑल कॅन बी डन. ऑफकोर्स द एक्झॅक्ट प्रोटोकॉल विल वेरी फ्रॉम वन ओ टी टू अनदर डिपेंडिंग ऑन द स्टाफ लेआउट अँड एव्हरीथिंग. ओके, सो प्लॅनिंग द CSSD, फर्स्ट लोकेट इट ॲज क्लोज टू द ओ टी एज पॉसिबल. So clean areas as close to the OT as possible, dirty areas as far away from the OT as possible. Okay. Determine what is going to be your sterilization load. That is depends on the surgeries you are doing every day and how many trays and drums you require per surgery. Because this again varies between surgeons. Some surgeons, they use open just one or two trays, others may open four or five trays. So it's all very subjective. Okay. So determine the load. Then determine the equipment and the specifications to handle that load. What size of autoclave we should go in for? There are lots of cleaning equipments available nowadays, washer disinfectors, ultrasonic cleaners, so on and so forth. So define the equipment and the specifications and their floor sizes, how much space they are going to take. Okay? Then make that first drawing and see whether there is a one-directional flow of the material. This is the most important part. So anything that comes to the cleaning area should flow in that one direction. So this is what they see in the NABH inspections also. Even if you are doing everything in the same room, you have to show one direction. So clean and dirty should never mix. Then there is no mixing of clean and dirty. Then don't forget about the air exhaust. This is going to be very important if you have everything in one room. Okay? So keep adequate space for storage, because there are lots of small things like packing material. If you have ETO, there's going to be rolls and rolls of packing material. If you have, there's going to be linen to be autoclaved. That's a storage that is aga lagte. Sterilized indicators ahet. There may be spare parts. There may be other things which they need to store there. or if the instruments are under the authorization of the CSSD, they may have to store spare instruments also to replace the ones that are damaged. So depends on the workflow, what areas you will need. Okay. So from the NABH aspects, for hospitals below 50 beds, a one room CSSD is what they do accept. But if you're going for full accreditation, then definitely a full-fledged CSSD, what they will expect. So for a one room, the room size should be adequate. So char theater sati dah by dah chek room dakholi na accept honar. So reasonably adequate space should be shown. Okay. Then the unidirectional flow of material has to be demonstrated. The staff also, they will ask to protocols and everything. And the separation of clean and dirty. That is, these three main things they will see in the inspection for below 50. Okay. In larger hospitals, they will expect more segregation. Say at least the cleaning section is separate, the sterile storage is separate. And of course, for full accreditation, it is a complete full-fledged CSSD that they will ask for. All the four sections, isolation, everything.